rays, they are matching with the traits or the shakti behind the nakshatra, or they are matching with the deity associated with the nakshatra. So how many queries do we get on a day-to-day basis that we are suffering with this, we are suffering with that? And here I would like to point, many of us do the Navgraha pujas. How many of us do the pujas or the serving of 27 nakshatras, trees? We are all interested. We have learned, we have seen people do the Navgraha pujas. Imagine a person serving 27 nakshatras, trees. The amount of power or amount of aura or the energy he or she can get. Have we ever thought about that? So let's go to the next. And I think it is the last nakshatra, which I took it on a very last moment as we are in Uttarabhadrapada. So Uttarabhadrapada, we all know, this is the later happy feet, the scorching pair with the Purvabhadrapada, the warrior star. And it is today's nakshatra as well. So the shakti associated with this is Varsho Dayamana Shakti, the power to bring rain, the cosmic rain, that's the key. Varsho means rain, Dayamana means the god. So Varsho Dayamana means the rain god who has the power to bring rain. And the tree or the plant associated with this nakshatra is Neem, Nimbha in Sanskrit. Body part associated, the lower legs, the calves, ailments, paralytic attack. We all know Bhadrapada nakshatras are associated with the Kundalini awakening. Paralytic attack, stomach problems, pain in the bones, chronic pains. Who's the lord of this nakshatra? Saturn. Chronic pains. So there were some interesting facts about Neems. Neem is called as Arista in Sanskrit, the word that means perfect, the complete and the imperishable, which is very self-explanatory. Neem in Sanskrit means the destroyer of leprosy and healer of the skin affections, which is again right here in the ailment part. In the ancient documents like Karak Samhita and Susruta Samhita, Neem is considered it is the medicinal properties are listed in this Samhitas.
Like endless properties.
Endless, endless. And I have only given some of them. It is also in the Ayurvedic text, it says Sarvo Roga Nivarani, a universal reliever of all the illnesses. So again, the neem cake, the residue of the seeds, is fed to livestock and the poultry. Increases the soil fertility, which is again associated with the shakti of this nakshatra, the fertility. The Brihat Samhita and the Varahamihira recommends the neem tree, if planted near the dwellings, near your household, the smallpox and the chickenpox were cured with the use of the neem leaves. So how many of us really does that? We are just cutting trees day by day. So, and there is a big mythology, I'm pretty sure you are aware of that, Jagannath Dham of Odisha. We all know every 12 years, they make the Krishna, Subhadraji and Balramji idols from the tree. Again, that is
Daru Brahma.
Yeah. Daru Brahma. There is another story of Kadamba as well, connected with Jagannath Puri, which is associated with Shatabisha. Neem has a very deep connection with Jagannath Dham. And that's separate itself is a very big presentation.
What did you say? Kadamba.
Kadam, which is a tree associated with Shatabisha. That's what Dr. Pai was mentioning me on the other day. There is a huge mythology with that tree as well.
Yeah, because there is a very famous, this is related to Krishna also, Kadamba tree.
Okay.
So that is why he's known as Kadamba Kanana.
Kadamba Kanana. Okay.
One who is dancing, you know, behind the below the Kadamba tree.
Right, right.
I was wondering if Balaramji has some connections because Balaramji and Shatabisha has connections. And okay. The deity of this is Ahirbhudanya, right?
Yes, yes. One of the Rudras, 11 Rudras.
And Ahirbhudanya is that sea serpent, right?
Yes, the water dragon.
Yes.
Again related to the fertility, the Kundalini.
Sheshnag is also related.
Yes, yes.
Some
yes.
connection will be there somewhere.
Absolutely, absolutely. So we all know neem has a lot of cooling properties, can be compared to rain qualities, which is again associated with this shakti behind this nakshatra. When it rains, the mother earth that is suffering from the heat and the cracks due to the droughts get relief. See how beautifully the neem is playing in the reforestation. Neem is indicated as having a calming and cooling effect, we all know. I personally use neem Colgate for my teeth all the time. So cooling effect on heat and redness. Again, the inflammation part came. Shows on the skin. And it is, just like we have mentioned, it is known as the queen of the skin in Ayurveda. Again, the Ayurveda saying. It's not we are saying or Babaji Ji is saying. And again, there was a connection, the medicinal god Dhanvantri, which has a connection with the Samudra Manthan, association with this tree. In fact, the neem may even be a divine origin. It is said when the Hindu demigod Garuda, on his way to heaven, with the elixir, the Amrit he was carrying, few drops fell on the same tree.
Wow.
So it was very fascinating when I was making this research. So many points I was getting, and again, these are just subtle points because we cannot talk about the full points here because that's going to take 300 slides. So this is the last slide, I would say. Again, some of the traits associated with the Uttarabhadrapada Nakshatra, the power to defeat enemies. It is known for this Nakshatra. They are adaptable, flexible, as compared to the Purva Bhadrapada. Kundalini awakening, we already spoke about that. Praiseworthy, extremely cordial, respectful of all. And I still remember while I say that, I think Bill Gates has moon in this nakshatra in Uttara Bhadrapada. So we can relate to him while we are doing this. So what are the traits of the neem plant? Flexible and adaptable. Again, totally connect with the traits of the Uttarabhadrapada. Neem is known as Nimbha in Sanskrit. Cloud that brings rains are called Nimbus. Such resemblance in the names as well. Look at the correlation. So it has everything to do with the rain and the rainforestation. Survives in the extreme heat conditions and can be grown in the most soil types. Beautiful. And some of the remedies, cooling properties, as we have discussed, related to the inflammation. Leprosy, again we have discussed, one of the ailments associated with the Uttarabhadrapada. Paralytic attack, the muscle weakness, we can use neem for the same thing. Natural insecticide used for treating food items. Neem oil used for repel mosquitoes. Machardani, which we in order like in India we used to use all the time. Anti-malaria properties again matches absolutely with the Uttarabhadrapada traits. So Babaji Ji say remedies are simple. Traits, we can see how beautifully it is matching with the qualities, with the shakti behind with each nakshatra. And we all know the traits, it's matching with each and every nakshatra as well. So,
regarding this only, I remember when I was very, very, very small, I used to stay in Dispur, in this water colony of, you know, this government officers, especially the IAS officers. So there, what used to happen is once every month, there used to be a car which used to come. This is around 22, 23 years back.
Okay.
Car will come like this and it will spread this, dhua, as you say, no? It's not dhua exactly what you say. I mean, I know the word in Assamese, I don't know the translation in Hindi or English. So it's like a gas which they spread so that the mosquitoes go away from the whole place.
Oh, yes. I remember they used to do the same thing in Delhi as well. Yeah.
So that is there, and they continued doing this for many years.
Right.
But then somebody told the people there that, why are you doing all this nonsense? Spreading pollution. Instead of that, what you can do, in every house, you can take this, that which they use in temples in India. Na? I don't know what is that called.
Right.
Where there this aarti is going on. You know, I mean the big one, not the small ones. Okay.
Right.
So they said, you can just do this and you can just burn neem leaves.
Okay.
Yeah. And in our home, in our that place, in our place, we had two neem trees.
Right.
And always we used to bring it and we used to burn from there.
Okay.
And where I have that is why I also remember, like, for example, in my childhood, many of my friends, my father's colleagues, sons and daughters, most of them used to fall sick very easily. But I rarely have any memory of falling sick, very rarely. And even my brother also, and even my mother and my father, in fact, my mother too, I have never seen her falling sick. Even, at least in those days, I remember. No? Because we used to use this neem and once in a month, my father used to ensure that once in a month, he will take bath only with the neem trees, with neem leaves, water. Leaf.
Yes.
Soap, no shampoo, nothing.
Right.
We do that. And sometimes what in my village they used to do, you know, they will take the leaves and they will make this chutney, the paste. And this they will apply throughout their body.
The men
will go to one place where there are no ladies, and the ladies will go to a place where there are no men. And then they will undress themselves completely and apply this in the whole of their body, you know, and then they would stay like that for some hours, you know, especially I know about this. So neem is like, I mean, there are no words. You can go on and on and on. And it will never be finished.
Yeah, there is another nakshatra just like the neem, which I have not taken here because there was still few homework I had to do, which was bale. Because bale itself, I was having 30-40 slides just on bale. Imagine. Because what is the nakshatra associated with bale is chitra. What is chitra shakti is life full of merits.
Okay.
And bale itself is a big subject which cures, and we can do as a remedial basis for thousands of diseases and ailments. So it is a never-ending research, never-ending subject. So we cannot take 27 nakshatras, even though I am doing my bit on that and slowly and steadily I'm going to cover all the nakshatras, but here we have taken only 5 nakshatras. So here we can see, just like you were mentioning, the Sheetala, it is also called the Sheetala, the cooling effect. Again, diseases caused by the hotness, inflammation, skin diseases, fevers, which is matching absolutely with the Shakti of the Uttara Bhadrapada. So it is amazing, Babaji ji. So how we can use this, let's come